Okay, this lesson is about color as far as color schemes and what colors go together, and when you put them together, what happens to that color. So I'm going to write color schemes. We have quite a bit to go over, so I'm going to divide the paper into a grid. Now the first one I'm going to go over is the primary colors. There are six primary colors. I'm going to draw six circles. Primary colors are blue, red, yellow, cobalt, magenta, and lemon yellow. It's very important that at this stage, high school and beyond, that you know that there are these six primary colors. If you go to a printer and you want a high quality print, it will use all of these colors and black and white. When the printer uses all six primary colors and black and white, that is going to be called a jaclé. A jaclé is actually French for to spray the colors, and it just gives a more accurate depiction of a piece. Most printers only use three primary colors. So if you want a high quality print, it should be a jaclé, which means it's using all six of these primary colors. Let's go ahead and fill these in. You can get a jaclé print Office Depot, most places that do things like Office Depot will make these. I think Vista, definitely, Vista Prints. It is not inexpensive. We've invested for the first time this year in our program, Asia Clay printer. Asia Clays will also cost more. To make and sell, because you are paying for the pigment quality. Now, as a final step, I also like to use Gamsol. Gamsol just helps pick up the pigment and blend it together. Starts to kind of act a little bit more like paint, like a watercolor. So make sure it's clean when you change colors. Those are your primary colors. Now we're going to see which of these colors mix, blend together, and how best to create color schemes. So the first set I'm going to do is called Cool Colors. I'm going to be drawing six circles. There's more than six cool colors, but just to give you an understanding, basic understanding, of how to make a cool color scheme, I'm going to do 6. So what colors do you think of when I say cool? So blue is usually the first thing we think of. Cobalt. I mix blue with, let's say, red. I'm going to make purple. I mix blue with yellow, I'm going to make green. Maybe I want the green to be even more of a type of blue, so blue-green. And then I can also make a blue purple. Green, and we're going to switch it up a little bit on that last one. I'm not going to do a blue purple. I'm going to do a fuchsia. Fuchsia is cobalt and magenta. So let's put in the colors. First is blue. And cobalt. Purple. I'm going to use red first because that is a weaker pigment than blue. And I want an equal amount of blue. So red and blue. Green, which is going to be yellow. And blue. And then I have a blue-green. going to be yellow. But mostly blue. And then fuchsia, which is going to be magenta and cobalt. Magenta is the first one I'm going to put down. And then cobalt. Now, all I have to do is blend them together. I'm going to use Gamsel, use a Q-tip, blending stump. Put a little bit more blue in this one. That's better. That looks more like a green instead of a yellowish green. That looks more like a green. Blue green. Is a cool color scheme. Next, I'm going to do a warm color scheme. I'm going to do 6 circles. What colors can I make? Let's do yellow. Think of the sun. Red. Orange. Magenta. Let's make an amber. And a red orange. Okay, so the first one's yellow. Next one's red. In case you're wondering what pencils, I'm using Artist Loft pencils. I got them at Hobby Lobby. Orange is next, and I'm going to use yellow first. It's a weaker pigment. And then red. I want to use an even amount. Magenta. Amber. Well, amber is a combination between lemon yellow and magenta. I'm going to put my lemon yellow first. And I want an equal amount of magenta. And then I have a red orange, so it's yellow. Now all I have to do is blend them together. Add a little bit more magenta to my amber. That's it. Those are all warm colors. Next, I'm going to do complementary color schemes. Complementary. I'm going to do six circles. And you need to think about, so in design, we use complementary colors quite a bit. If you think about, well, Christmas is coming up, so the colors you think of are red and green. Now, when I mix these two together, it's going to make a brown. And it's going to gradually get rid of these pigments. When you are getting rid of the main pigment of a color, it's called desaturation. So, I'm going to color my red in first. And then I'm going to make my green on the other side, which is yellow. When I teach these lessons, I purposely don't use green or any of the other secondary or tertiary colors, because the more you mix colors together, the easier it's going to be to match any color that you see. It's a little bit harder, but it pays off. Okay, I'm going to start from green and go to red. So I'm going to start with green over here. So I'm going to make green again. And blue. Blend those together. And I'm going to add a little bit of red. Since I'm close to green, I'm only going to add a little bit of red. You need to make a greenish type of brown. Now you know how to make a greenish type of brown. So I'm going to make green again. Blend it together. I'm going to add a lot more red this time. Probably about half and half. See, it's starting to make brown. So I'm going to make green again. Now I'm getting over towards red, so I'm going to start adding a lot more red. Okay, last one, I'm going to make green. But I don't want a lot of green in this last one. I'm going to use a lot of red. There's our first set of complementary colors. So we're going to do at least three complementary colors. So the next one is a complementary color scheme. I'm going to do six circles. And we're in Florida, so there's a popular team in Florida called Florida Gators, and their colors are blue and orange. Again, in between, when I mix them together, it's going to make a type of brown. And when you take away the main pigment of a color, it's called desaturation. I'm going to stop there for now because this is kind of a long lesson. So this is going to be the end of part one, and then there will be a part two.